Rhodesian holiday. We're just arriving home in our 1955 Morris Oxford with the AA badge on the front. That's the Automobile Association. Here's me playing in the sandpit under the canopy which my dad took from his truck and put over the sandpit. And here we are with the dogs, Timmy and Ranger, in the backyard. And it's time to go on holiday. So, after a little fooling around with this piece of cloth here, which the dogs like to fight over with us, finally on equal terms here. Here we are polishing up the car for the trip. The shirt is from the Wembley Lions, the sports team in London that my dad used to support. Paint didn't last very long on cars in those days unless you waxed it regularly. So here we are leaving Luanshya with all our luggage and heading down the main road. Typical Zambian trees at that time. My mum didn't want to go too fast for this scene. Obviously didn't drive around at that speed all the time. She's even got the lights on, the brake lights. Along the way, this would be probably Kapirium Pashi or perhaps Broken Hill, where we'd stop for refreshments along the way. And I looked at some of my close cousins. Rhodesian Railways locomotive, pulling freight, lots of it. Could have been ore, could have been coal. I don't know which way they're going. This one looks like it's going south, actually. Broken Hill, by the way, is now called Chattaway. It was named after the original Broken Hill in Australia because they mine similar metals there. Lead and zinc in that case. Yes, this is where the dirt road starts. There were some bad stretches. This is relatively good. But now we're back into tar again. I think we're possibly entering this. I don't know if it might be Lusaka, it might be Kabwe, but now we're on our way south. We've reached the Victoria Falls already. These rondavels were rented out and they were serviced. They would make your beds and do your laundry for you and cook your meals. And relatively inexpensive at the time, as I remember. I borrowed my mom's pocket knife. I went off to carve my initials in the tree. All of this has been swept away since and replaced with something a bit more upscale. But those were days when that was plenty good enough and very comfortable. And the falls. As seen from upstream, looking across the broad, shallow expanse of the river upstream of the falls, as opposed to the narrow, fast-flowing gorges downstream. But we can get closer than that to the falls. Here we are, we're still on the northern side, and we're looking at the falls from the edge, as close as we're allowed to walk to the edge anyway. This definitely wasn't the dry season. Plenty of water there. When we visited again in 1997, it was the end of the dry season, and we walked all the way to the middle of the river on dry rocks across the lip of the falls. But here, there's far too much water for anybody to try that. Of course, wherever you have mist in the air, you get a rainbow. Now, we have to put the water back at night, otherwise we'd run out. So a little trick shot by my dad. And here are some of our local relatives. Just keeping a spot warm for us, I suppose. This would probably be taken from the railway bridge, I think, or one of the footbridges. That's called the boiling pot. The water falls about 95 meters there. This is the famous Victoria Falls Railway Bridge, also road bridge. Still exists. They maintain it regularly, and it's probably got another 50 years of life left in it if it is carefully maintained. At the last maintenance, they scraped off 13 coats of old lead paint to get down to the bare metal and recover it. And here's my mom, recognizing that she's supposed to walk toward the camera. It looked completely natural. Okay, a little closer up to the edge so that you can see the amount of water falling. It's quite an amazing sight. Combination of height and width, total volume of water flowing, makes it very impressive among waterfalls. There are higher ones, and there are wider ones. But not too many that have both the height and the width and the volume of water. There were stairs where you could walk down all the way to the bottom if you so were inclined. Quite slippery rock stairs. You'd have to wear good shoes with good grip. We went down at least far enough to get this shot. I seem to remember it was quite the tiring stairs to get back up. Now we've gone across to the other side, I think, and we're at the Victoria Falls Hotel. Looking at it from the south side. I guess I'm checking a map there. Now we've taken the seats on a commercial game watching flight. So we got to fly over the sights and get to see the falls from the air. These days it might be a helicopter flight, but in those days it was a small aircraft, small airplane. And when we were walking on the edge in 1997, we were the attraction that the helicopters came to take a look at. So upstream the water is quite stagnant, or at least slow flowing. Here we have some of the game. We saw some elephants there. These flights were taken over the game reserve area so that tourists could get a good glimpse of the wildlife there. Fairly large herds of animals were there. Elephants, probably a couple of dozen in each group. Looked like a wildebeest, I'm not sure. These zebras, there are some zebras in this movie. Those might be them. Oh, here we go. Another African sunset. So the next day we would get on the riverboat, and the riverboat would take us upstream where we'd stop for refreshments. I think this was before we got on the boat. We stopped and had lunch. Looks like I found a cat. And here I am coming down with my dad to the boat, which means my mom must have taken this shot. So from the boat, you got to see various creatures that would inhabit these islands in the middle of the river. There's probably an animal in there, but I'm not sure if I can see it. Some of the things we saw included crocodiles, some of which looked quite mean, but very lazy. That's our sister boat. They've just finished their run and are going the other direction. So we're going to pass them with some blowing of steam whistles. This guy decided that post was put there just for him. Yep, that's a crocodile. I know it looks like a log, but it's a crocodile. On a log, by the look of it. Or perhaps on a sandbank. That was a hangar in which they stored flying boats. The Sunderland flying boats from the UK came out and landed there when there wasn't yet a runway in the city of Livingston. And they'd maintained it. Here we have more of our close relatives hanging out in the trees. And this is probably at the spot where we stopped our boat to have our lunch. For some reason, this one bites his friend's tail. Not sure why. They were quite accustomed to being fed peanuts and crackers by the tourists. So here they come for them. Mom and I disappearing down a dark pathway into the forest. Of course, there has to be tea. This is, after all, a society of people from Britain. So there was the tea. And he was enjoying the peanuts from my hand. Come on, guys, take it out of my hand. You gotta take it from me. People with riverside homes. And this was our laundry being done. Irons that were heated on the fire and like a barbecue pit, and then used to iron all the clothes and bedding. You ironed everything in Africa to kill the eggs laid by the putzi fly, otherwise they'd hatch into worms that would eat into your skin and bury themselves inside you. So everything got ironed to kill those eggs. Okay, we're locking up. And we're off for a day's trip, I suppose. Next, on our way to the Wankie Game Reserve, now called Hwangwe. Where you stayed in more rondavels, similar accommodation. These ones were square, so they weren't rondavels. But individual family units, which you rented by the night. And then you got in your car, and the signs said, stay in your car and stay on the road, which you were well advised to do. Right, so we have some kind of, looks like an impala, actually. A few of them there. Something larger, possibly a kudu. Female, no horns. I'm not much of an expert on these animals, I have to tell you. A water buck with the target painted at the back end. Okay, impala. Graceful little antelope. It has nothing much in common with the large barges that Chevrolet was selling under that name at the time. They can certainly run and leap. The warthog, the pig of Africa. Lots of those around. Plenty more warthogs where they came from. Now we have something larger. Buffalo. Have you ever seen a buffalo? In a huffalo? Somehow that little skinny tree is able to support that large animal reminds me of the song, The Big Baboon One Night in June. He married them very soon. They went off on their Abba Dabba honeymoon. That's a guinea fowl, the chicken of Africa. And of course we have ducks too. Everybody has ducks somewhere in this world. And no prizes for guessing what that is. There's usually more than one when you see them. Those ones have decided to take off at speed. One of them is kind of curious and stopped to take a look, and then decided to catch up. Mom, wait for me. I think that's a sable with a curly horns. Not sure. Could be a kudu. You'll have to look it up. And now the lions. And a crocodile that was... You couldn't make it move. We tried shouting at it, clapping our hands, making noises. And it just sat there. As did these lions for a while, occupying their share of the road, so we didn't feel like trying to drive past them. Now they decided to come and investigate us, so we and the other cars around all decided it was a good idea to back up. As you see, there are quite a few lions there. That would be the Zambian fish eagle, the national symbol. A rather unfriendly elephant that we encountered just as we were leaving the park. Our clutch had been damaged and changing gears made loud noises. And the elephant wasn't terribly impressed with the sound. In those days, a sable coat was something that many women desired to wear. It has a beautiful fur. Of course, fur is out of fashion now. Looks like we found some more zebra. How many lions can you see in this picture? I think there are at least five. I've been asked what kind of lenses we used here. We had a standard lens and a short telephoto. The short telephoto only doubled the size of the images. We are quite close to these creatures. Yeah, I like the shade better over here. It's all about finding shade when you live in Africa. Let's go to sleep. These two were playing it. How many of us do you see? One would hide behind the other, and they'd change places. More people in Africa are killed by buffalo than by any other wild animal. There are just so many of them, and they're very big and strong. Can defend themselves quite well. And that ends our trip to the Wankie Game Reserve. My dad's humor here. Refreshments will be served. If you're lucky.